Right, hi there everyone. This was only going to be a one-part video, but lots of ideas occurred to me. So what I thought I'd do is turn this into a two-parter, or maybe even a three-parter. I know most YouTube channels have nice intros and extros, and they don't leave the ugly bits on the end of their videos and stuff. Please bear with me. It's the ideas that are taking me away with this one, and I'll try and tidy the channel up and make it a bit more beautiful, and the videos a bit more beautiful as we go on, and I'll make a starter thing. But 1,000 oscillators. Obviously, with my crummy speakers, and by the time it's been YouTube, you can't hear any. I can't really hear what it is 1,000 oscillators sound like. So what I decided, with a bit of additional coding over the last couple of days, I've been kind of obsessively trying to get this done. Is that you need to see what the waveform looks like. So from a simple bit of code that creates a WAV file, I've now taken over actual control of the sound device, and that's going to involve me in writing a parallel thread because the sound's got to be looked after, and also some X Windows programming because I want to. This is the nerdy bit, by the way, so you can fast forward on a bit if you just want to hear the 1,000 oscillators. So what does the X Windows part is going to be needed to actually draw the waveform. So if you look at my compile line now, I've forgotten to optimize it actually, so let's just stick that in the beginning. Minus O G. That's like your general optimization of the code. So what I'm going to do is actually let the code run, and then what we should see is 1,000 oscillators all in phase starting. It's going to run now this time. Last video I didn't let it, I just let it run and then I gave you a WAV file. This is actually going to create the WAV file, save it, and then it's going to play it. So the player is actually built into the code now. I'll put the code on GitHub in the link below. Scope, I called that window, you see, because it's an oscilloscope. So in a minute it'll start playing and we can watch the waveform. But what occurred to me was that with 1,000 oscillators all playing at once, in fact they're going to a lot of the time cancel each other out. So I've had to really raise the gain a bit on this. And also, I think Sam will find this with his 1,000 oscillators that actually the more oscillators you have, the quieter it becomes because they're all cancelling each other out. This runs for 1 minute, so when it wakes up, it'll run for a minute. And what we start with is 1,000 oscillators all producing a clean sine wave. And then by the end of the run, the 1,000 oscillators have drifted in frequency by about sort of 1% in opposite in either direction, either up or down, and the waveform has changed from a sine to a square. But it's quite fun to watch it. There's red for the left channel, blue for the right. I've also thought there's going to be part three of this video, which I'll talk about in a minute, but hopefully this is going to suddenly wake up, because at the moment it's doing maths. It's doing all that 1,000 oscillators, I don't know how many points, it's CD quality, so it's 44,100 points for every second, two of them for left and right channel, and then it's got to do 1,000, calculate 1,000 sine waves at each point, and then it does all my clipping and all the other bits and bobs, so it takes quite a while to run. Then, yeah, part three, I think it's time to go a bit mad. I'll just dig in my drawer. Part three, we think, is going to involve Raspberry Pi. Oh, here it goes. Thank you. So part three of this, see, it's, there's probably some bugs in my code because there's an under on the code there, but it broadly works. Part three is going to involve Raspberry Pi. I've got two, and a couple of Bluetooth speakers. So I reckon I can probably get 3,000 oscillators. So if I can get each Raspberry Pi to do 1,000, and the PC itself that this is all happening on to do 1,000, that's 3,000. So roll on part three. I hope in this video you could actually hear the sound a bit better. Forgive my naive use of the OBS Studio software. Hope you enjoyed it. Thank you for watching. And if you've got any ideas about 1,000 oscillators, sine, square, should they play a tune, what should we do with them next, put some comments below and I'll act on it. But my next thing is to try 3,000 with a Raspberry Pi, a few Bluetooth speakers and God knows what. So see you in part three. Thanks everyone. Bye.